High up between the ski runs at Mount Washington sits a facility for the captive breeding of Vancouver Island marmots, an endangered species. They hibernate for 6 or 7 months of the year. So during the winter time, the marmots are inside in their nest boxes hibernating. And the building itself is actually completely buried in snow. I always call it the Fortress of Solitude. I was always fascinated with animals. It was a no-brainer for me that I wanted to be a veterinarian.
He was cooperative. Kind of nice to see. Okay, 1 meter per minute. Tail, 18.7. Neck circumference, 25.0.
I did mixed animal practice, so dogs and cats and horses and cattle.
So 3.90.
I had an opportunity to volunteer on a bunch of wildlife projects here on Vancouver Island. Yeah, it just sort of took off from there.
So we'll give her 0.07 ivermectin. Okay.
The Vancouver marmot has been on Vancouver Island for thousands of years, and certainly the indications are that it was here prior to the last ice age.
And she's in sternal.
The 1990s, the population declined precipitously. If the program hadn't started, this species would almost certainly be extinct by now. We're actually looking at a population that's about 358 is sort of what we determined last season. What we've got is an array of cameras and monitors to actually keep track of the marmots. Every day, it's like you can almost watch them growing.
Yeah, it's kind of neat.
It's just endlessly fascinating to be invested in the lives of a species like this. I think because this is a species in need. There's a litter of three here, we know that. And during hibernation, that really becomes a, you know, like a very tight ball of marmots. So what we try to do is figure out the best genetic pairings and get those marmots together. But we call it matchmaking. Their offspring are the candidates for release.
Looks marmot to you, not to me. So it's marmot release day. So it's like biggest day of the year, the marmot calendar.
We're going to have the marmots in the cages. We're going to strap them onto our pack frames here and hike them down to a burrow to be released. And Sweetie's got some earplugs because they can whistle pretty loud.
I have no idea.
There's no way that one person could do this by themselves. A marmot by itself is not going to be able to survive as well, right? And the thinking is, you know, if you have more eyes watching in the colony, it's safer because predators will be detected with greater frequency.
Oh, there's a bear up at the top.
There's a bear. We're kind of like a colony too.
We can see the helicopter now, guys. You can see it above the horizon. Get these marmots in the shade and then we can get them onto the pack. Down to two. You got her. So you guys, when we're heading down the hill, be wary of the balance shifting. If the marmots run from one side to the other, it could really throw you off balance a little bit. And keep voices down to a minimum. And like if we're stopping, make sure the marmots are in the shade. Okay, right, let's head down the hill.
It's like a whole year-long process. of getting them to this point. Working on this is kind of like having your heart slowly pulled out of your chest. And you know that they're not all going to survive. You know, it's kind of like your kid. You watch out for them for their entire lives, and then they get to the point of independence, and you know that that's a necessary step in their development, but it doesn't stop you worrying about all the things that are out there in the big bad world.
All right. She's just facing the wrong way. It doesn't feel like a safe spot for her to go into. Mm-hmm. So she's stressed out and she's clinging to the bottom of the trap. She's a captive red marmot, so she doesn't know what a burrow looks like. So she's just in fight or flight mode. And we've got to encourage her to get past that and take those few steps. Can you push her foot back with the pole from your side, just so she's not got traction?
Oh, she turned around.
Get some peanut butter on a biscuit.
That's not a bad idea, actually. Get a long, can we get a long stick of some kind?
Good.
She's eating it.
Oh, yay!
So we just secured the trap. We're going to leave her for a bit. Just, she's facing the right way. So we just got to let her do her thing.
That that marmot is in that huge landscape. They've never walked on a steep slope before. They've never walked on talus where, you know, it gives way underneath their feet. Then they've got all these food plants available to them as well. They get natural vegetation, but they never had that abundance.
It's pretty amazing. You know, you think about this marmot, you know, has been inside the burrow for an hour to 2 hours now. But this is its first time ever in the wild. So for it to be willing to come out and explore even in just 2 hours is pretty incredible.
They are in a whole new world, and it's the world that they should be in. Ken Armitage, he passed away this spring, but he is the marmot guru. People used to ask him, well, marmots, what are they good for? And his response was, I don't know, what are you good for? You know, we can't live on this planet just by ourselves. And these species have a right to exist and to get our support too, especially if we're having a negative influence on them. What is the most unique thing about the planet? It's life.